In this video, we will study the action of a free relativistic particle and how constraints equations appear when dealing with the Lagrangian and Hamiltonian formulation of relativistic mechanics. Let's start with a definition. The action of a relativistic particle that travels along a world line C is given by minus mc squared times the integral over its world line. Since the infinitesimal world line element is given as the square root of minus dx mu dx mu, we can parameterize this world line with the parameter tau. For this video, we use a mostly plus Minkowski metric, which is the usual choice for general relativity and string theory, as opposed to the mostly minus metric used in particle physics. That's the reason for the minus signs here. This is the action of a relativistic point particle of mass m traveling in a d-dimensional Minkowski spacetime. One thing to note here is that this action is invariant under a reparametrization of tau. That is, if we change from tau to a function tau tilde, which depends on tau. The transformation factor from the integral measure and the one under the square root cancel exactly, leaving the action invariant. And by the way, since the action and the Lagrangian of a system are related by an integral, we can read off the Lagrangian for this point particle. Let's go a step further towards describing the dynamics of this particle. The conjugated momentum is defined as the derivative of the Lagrangian with respect to the time derivative of a coordinate. Since we have d coordinates summarized in x mu, we will also get d conjugated momenta. This calculation is rather straightforward, and we arrive at m x dot mu divided by the square root of minus x dot squared. These momenta are not completely independent though. If we calculate p squared, we see that it is equal to minus m squared. If we define some function phi as p squared plus m squared, it is always identical to zero, regardless of the exact configuration of the system. This is called a constraint. More precisely, since we only use the definition of the conjugated momenta and did not use any equation of motion, it is a primary constraint. A constraint like this appears when we have a system where we cannot express the velocities x dot uniquely in terms of the momenta p. But this is necessary for the Legendre transformation to go to the Hamiltonian formulation. One can show that the number of primary constraints is equal to the amount of zero eigenvalues of this matrix, called the Hessian matrix, or just Hessian in short. To be fair, it does not look much like a matrix, but if we substitute the definition of the conjugated momentum, we clearly get an object with two indices, which for our purposes can be seen as a matrix. Now, what does this constraint mean? Systems that have constraints are called singular, and for a singular system, the dynamical evolution with respect to the parameter tau is determined by the Hamiltonian H, which is given by the sum of the canonical Hamiltonian plus all constraints multiplied with some parameter. The canonical Hamiltonian is defined like this, and for our system, it vanishes, independent of the exact configuration. You should check this yourself. So this means the dynamics of the system are completely determined by the constraint. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.